Here we have a simplified version of a solar cell, and it consists of, down here, a very thin silicon layer, and then we have 1 millimeter thick of adhesive and glass. The length of this solar cell is 0.5 meters. Its width is 0.2 meters. It's on an insulated surface, which means that we're looking at the heat transfer in this direction. We have an air temperature of 25 degrees C, and we have a free stream velocity of 5 meters per second. We're also given a radiative resistance, which we'll use in part two of this problem. And we know that the heat transfer through the cell is 100 watts, and what we need to do is find the temperature of the silicon as well as the temperature at the surface. In order to be able to solve for this problem, we're given conductivities, we're given resistance, but the one thing that we don't have is the convective heat transfer coefficient for the surrounding air. So we're going to have to find that using a correlation. The way we approach it is we find an appropriate correlation for the Nusselt number, which is that H that we need, times L over the thermal conductivity of the fluid, which is the air. And this is a function of the Reynolds number as well as the Prandtl number. We can look up the Prandtl number, but the first thing that we're going to have to do is solve for the Reynolds number. And in order to do that, we're going to have to look up properties at the film temperature. And the film temperature is an average between the surrounding temperature, which is 25 degrees C, and the surface temperature. And because we don't know the surface temperature, we have to guess. What I guessed was a film temperature of 320 Kelvin. And as you'll see in part two of the screencast, that's very, very close. We find the Reynolds number, looking up properties at that temperature. That will determine our regime. In other words, is it laminar or turbulent? And the reason you need to find that out is, depending on the flow regime, you choose different correlations. Once we find that out, and we know that this is a flat plate, we can find our correlation, solve for our Nusselt number, and finally, from that, we'll get our H. Let's start with the Reynolds number, which is the velocity times the length of the plate divided by the kinematic viscosity. And when we look that up at 320 Kelvin, we find that that's 1.7 times 10 to the minus 6 meters squared per second. And so our Reynolds number ends up being 1.4 times 10 to the 6th. So any Reynolds number that's greater than 5 times 10 to the 5th for a flat plate indicates that the flow is turbulent. So we look at our list of correlations and we find a correlation for turbulent flow over a flat plate, and that's that the Nusselt number is going to equal 0.664 Reynolds to the 1/2 Prandtl to the 1/3. So we look up the Prandtl number at 320 Kelvin, and we find that that's 0.706. Let's put our numbers in here. Our Nusselt number is 717. Now we have to find our convective heat transfer coefficient. That's the Nusselt number times the thermal conductivity of the fluid divided by the length. And again, we look up this thermal conductivity at 320 K, and that equals 2.69 times 10 to the minus 2 watts per meter Kelvin. So now let's put it all together. And when we calculate that, we find that we have a convective heat transfer coefficient of 38.6 watts per meter squared Kelvin. And in part two of the screencast, you'll see how we use this heat transfer coefficient to solve for our temperatures.